I know. I'm not dead. I'm here. But yeah, Happy New Year. I hope you guys had an amazing new year and everything of that. I'm sorry I've been MIA, and I will, like, my schedule is really, really tough, but I will be, I will really be trying to, upload often because I love talking to you guys and I love doing this. But yeah, so today I'm going to be like talking, like a get ready with me talking, like favorite products, like my go-to makeup look. Yeah, that's gonna be today's thing, and I'm also gonna be talking to you guys through all of it. And yes, I don't know if you can see, but I have pink hair, and I am like, look at it, it's pink, and I'm so in love with it. I want it more pink, but for now it's like this tiny pink, but I want it, I'm sorry, my phone, but I want it more pink. So yeah, let's get right into the video. And my mirror, my big mirror is right there, so if I'm looking that way, it's because I have a big mirror right there. And you know, makeup, you need to look at yourself. So yeah, I love doing videos for you guys, and if you have any suggestions, like what should I do next, just comment down below. And yeah, with the video. Okay, so I am going to be starting with my Kiko Milan. Wait, I'm not gonna be starting with that. I'm gonna tie my hair away because I hate having makeup. I mean, not makeup on my face. What? I hate having hair on my face. I love doing this. Like, I'm crazy. Okay, so I'm going to be starting with my Kiko Milano Perfect Base Corrector. Is like a primer. It's supposed to be like a mattifying primer. I don't know about that, but it's the primer that I have now because I have a lot of samples and I don't want to waste my samples. So yeah, it's like 3 o'clock. I've had, like, today was my first day back at college and it was horrible. I already got like so many assignments, and yeah, but you know, everything good, like, study is great, you know, if you want to study. I love studying. That's maybe, like, my problem, that I like studying. That is my problem. This is, like, my go-to foundation, so I'm going to be mixing my Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless, but it doesn't, like, mattify me at all. Like, I know, but it mattifies. Okay, it's not good at mattifying because I'm oily as hell, but it's good, and the color matches me really well. But I'm going to be fixing it with the CoverGirl Ready Set Gorgeous in 120 Nude Beige, and this is 128 Warm Beige, so they're both beige. But I'm going to be mixing them because I want to finish this, and this oxidizes a lot on me. And yeah, I like mixing it with this one. So I'm going to be mixing it on the back of my Bath & Body Works palette, which I got this idea from the Taylor. Love you, girl. I got this idea from her, and I just don't want to get my hand all dirty because I don't want to ruin my shirt, because I love my shirt today. So yeah, I'm going to be mixing that right now. And to that mixture, I'm going to be, like, spraying some setting spray. This is the Boscia White Charcoal Mattifying Makeup Setting Spray. I really like this setting spray. I got this as a sample because I want to try it out. Like, not a sample, like a travel size. I'm shaking it because it has white charcoal. So fancy. And I got this trick from, I think it was Nikki Tutorials. Like, she was doing something on Kat Von D, and she did this, and I was like, that is such a great idea. So she just, like, sprayed the setting spray on the foundation to make it last longer, and then she mixed it, and yeah, to me, like, it has worked, on me. Like, it does work. So I'm going to be mixing that on the palette, and then applying that on my face. It, like, mattifies me more, you know? So, yeah, I'm going to be spreading a ton on my chin because, you know, problem areas. I'm looking at my mirror. Oh, that was great. I just put my, wow, that was amazing. That was a magic trick. You didn't know that, huh, did you? So, yeah, this is, what was I going to say? I forgot. So, I'm going to be taking my dirty ass, what's this? Like, Physicians Formula thingy. I broke it. It's broken. I bought a new one. I'm waiting for that to come in the mail. But until then, we're just gonna use that one. Ooh, this is, like, covering really well today. Like, I'm sorry. Like, today, the coverage is spot on. Like, I missed I mixed like the right amount because the coverage is there. So a little bit down the neck. And then my nose, because you know, freckles and pores and all that good stuff. Like, freckles are not bad. I love freckles. But you know, most people don't like freckles. Ooh, I saw this thing. It was like a freckle, like a tattoo for your nose that it gave you freckles, and I was like, really? Like, has it gotten to that point that people want freckles? And it's like, I don't know. Like, I remember when freckles were not that, like, nobody wanted freckles, and they would do everything to cover their freckles and everything, and now it's like, ooh, freckles, you have freckles. Like, what? What is wrong with size? Adding a little bit on my chin because, you know, not freckles, acne. and yeah. Like, the coverage this is giving me today is really nice. And it's not, I don't think it's the coverage. I think that I think that my skin is, like, getting better. I was sick, like, this, literally the first 2 weeks of January, I was sick. So that was maybe why I had so much acne, because, ooh, did I just mess up my shirt? Yes, I did. Dang it. Messed up my shirt. Because I was sick and I was, like, covering my face a whole lot. And, like, you know, bacteria. So, let's put this aside for now. I am going to be, like, I have this ritual when I do my under eye concealer, because my under eyes are, like, gray. And they're really deep. Like, I have really deep wrinkles here on the folds of my eyes. And, yeah. So, I recently bought this, and I am in love with it. It's my Tarte Shape Tape Concealer, which has been the rave. And I waited so long for this. It was always out of stock. It's in the shade Light Neutral. I think it's a little bit too light for me. But I don't care. I love it. It's great. Yeah, it was, like, sold out forever, and every time, like, I went on the site, it says, oh, that shade was sold out, and I was like, really? Like, why aren't other shades, well, this is really messed up, why aren't there other shades? Like, the other shades are sold out, but, yeah, they finally restocked it. I am so excited. I bought it, like, I didn't even, let's just fix you right there. I didn't even think about it. I was like, give it to me, I need it. So, yeah, I'm going to be taking, oh, I didn't say this. This is, like, the NYX HD Studio Photogenic Powder, like, loose translucent powder, because I have a ritual that was what I was saying. Like, I just conceal one under eye and then immediately set it because it creases. So I'm going to be doing, like, one eye at a time, and I have to set everything up over here so that it doesn't crease on me. And this thing, it has a lot of product. And the wand is huge, so, yeah. And I'm, again, using this sponge thingy. I'm going to set my concealer. And, yeah, you guys can see, like, it's slightly too light for me. But I don't care, because I love it. So, a little bit on the lid to, like, What was the word that I was looking for? Like, make it even? That's the word. So, yeah. It's not creasing now because you're on camera, huh? That's what you're doing, isn't it? So, I'm going to be taking on the same sponge. I'm going to be, like, trying to bake this thing. Because, yeah. Beauty thing. Trying to be more beauty-ish. Trying. That is the key word, trying. So, yes. Looking great, looking ghostly, but that is all part of the plan, you know? Okay, other eye. This is going great so far. Too much product there. Going great so far. Then a little bit down is the nose because, you know, again, doing beauty tricks that I don't know how to do, but let's pretend that we do. On the upper lip. And yeah, I'm not going to do anything else because I don't know how to do that. Concentration. almost done. Even though, like, it's a really thick concealer, I love it. Blends so easily. Like, it's just so pretty. Like, I love this so much more. It just, it's so, it doesn't crease that much. And so easy to blend. And, whew, I'm looking crazy right now. So I'm just trying to bake, you know, if that is even what I'm doing. I don't know what I'm doing. Do you know what I'm doing? I don't know what I'm doing. But yes, finished with that. And now I'm going to set my face, like my whole face, with the Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Powder in the shade 220 Natural Beige. Kind of a bit of a dent in there. So I'm just going to set my whole face, like including and wipe away the white powder under my eyes with this powder. So yeah, and this is like, I don't know, this is a Bella Pro brush. And it's like that. And I like it for powder. So yeah, just like tapping it or whatever, just placing powder all over your face. I have something in my eye. Great. Do I look good? Yes. So we are going to just put some eyelid primer for our shadows because, shadows. I'm using the Milani eyeshadow primer. I don't know, I bought this, I don't remember how long ago, but I'm just gonna be using that for my eyeshadow primer a tad bit because it's like, it's consistency, it's not, it's thick, but it's not like, what was I gonna say? Where was I going with that? I don't know. Like, it's a thick consistency, but it's not, yeah, it doesn't have color or anything. Like, it just blends. What am I trying to say here? I don't know. I'm going to be taking my Coastal Scents 88 palette, original. This is like my first big palette that I bought. And I'm going to be taking like a fluffy brush. Going to be taking my tapered fluffy brush. And I'm going to be defining my crease with, let's see if I can do this, with like a mixture of these two colors right here. So yeah, it's like a transition color. So I'm gonna be using those two on like my crease, you know. Okay, now I'm taking a big fluffy brush. This is Mirabella. Okay, so I blended that out. Now I'm going to be taking my Naked 3 palette, which first high-end makeup I ever bought. Like, you know, love it. I'm going to be taking my Naked 3 palette and my, again, the like tapered fluffy brush blending, whatever this is called. I'm going to be taking a tad bit of Nooner on, again, on the crease, just defining it a little bit. Like, more on the inner corners of my eyes. Just a little bit because I like the undertones of this shade. So I like that again with my big fluffy brush. Just blending it all out. Again, also from this palette, I'm going to be taking Strange, which is my favorite like highlighting shade, like under eye, under brow bone highlighting shade. And I'm going to be taking like this brush from, what is this? Miss Glam or something Glam, and it's an angled IW20. It has a little rhinestone. I'm going to be taking just Strange under my brow bone because I love this shade as like a highlighter. Like, look at that. Great, awesome, pretty. Again, from that Coastal Scents 88 palette, I'm going to be taking this shade, like these two shades. Do you see that? These two like peachy orangey shades on a flat shader brush. Where is my, here it is. It's also from Coastal Scents. It's the BRCN02. Wow, that's a lot of name for a little brush. I'm gonna be taking those like the lightest shades and just applying them on my lid. So like lightening up my lid. Take like a small angled fluffy brush, and with the initial two shades right here, I'm going to be doing that on my lower lash line. Okay, now for my favorite part of this whole look, I'm going to be taking this NYX eyeshadow, like single eyeshadow. What is this called? It's Fireball. Love this eyeshadow. Pigmentation is hella crazy with this one. So I'm going to be taking my fluffy brush, and I'm just going to apply this little shade, which I love. I really love this shade, on my crease, and that's going to be like the bam of this whole look. See how that just blends, and the color, love this shade. And it's like a coppery, it's literally a penny color. I don't know if you guys can see that. Don't think so, but it's literally like a penny, like a penny color, and I love this shade so much. So we're going back again, like not back again, but back on this, in this palette, in the Naked 3. I'm going to be taking Dust, which is like the really light shimmer one, right here, this one. And I'm going to just add that on my inner corner, for an inner corner highlight, because that's important, you know. I'm going to go again with the NYX, with that NYX shade, and just apply it on the lower lash line with the fluffy brush that we used. For like the fluffy brush that we used for the other color. See? It looks so pretty now. Okay, we are done with the eyeshadow. Now, I am going to be applying my worn down, like Rimmel Scandal Eyes liner. It's like a nude liner, whatever nude liner you really want. On the waterline. Now I'm going to be doing my eyebrows, and as always, the same product that I use for my eyebrows is the Milani Brow Fix, the blonde shade. So yeah, I'm just gonna be like lightly filling in my eyebrows. I don't need it, but I like it, you know. So lightly filling in. Now I'm going to be taking my NYX Control Freak Brow Gel. It's a clear brow gel. I hope it's clear. Well, it was clear. And whoop! Dab my finger. I'm just setting my brows. I do this like weird thing with my brows that I brush them up first and then I brush them down. So I do like this first to like coat all my brow hairs. Can you see that? Like I brush them up and then like I set them in place and they look like they're supposed to look like that. I don't know. I like it. With this look, I don't like having like a dark eye, like a ton of wing. This is my Ico London Skinny Liner, felt tip liner. I really want to find like a really good liner, so if you guys have a really good liner that you guys like know of, just comment down below, because this is like, it's good, but it's not like a liner that I really like that much, you know. Like it's not like holy grail eyeliner, like I love this eyeliner. It's not, so just I want one like that. I'm just gonna do like a little, not like wing, just line my eyes. careful without, you know, messing everything up. So I just line it a little bit. And then I'm adding like a tiny bit wing. Just like that. Just a flick. It's not a wing, it's a flick. Yeah? I'm doing a little flick. And I hope that the other eye comes out the same, because it's not, but I'm gonna be really mad because it won't. I look really pretty, don't I? I know. So again, concentration, because I'm gonna mess this eye up real quick, so I'll be right back. So I'm gonna be curling my lashes with just a normal eyelash curl, and I'm going to be applying my favorite mascara, which is like the Voluminous Butterfly Intensa mascara. This one right here, real pretty. So yes, let's do that. And I put heaps of mascara on with the mascara. You know that everybody has like that mascara face. What's mine? Like, I can't see because I'm so concentrated. I probably look really dumb, but. Oh, if you guys want a wish haul, like, I've been buying such, like, tons of stuff through Wish. So if you guys want a wish haul, like this video. Mascara, done. I don't have batteries, so let's finish this up real quick. Now I'm going to be just contouring as if I knew how to with my Maybelline, like, contour kit, palette thing. It's like contour, blush, and highlighter. I never used a blush, never used a highlighter. Hopefully use it for the contour, which is what I bought it for. But it's a pretty blush, it's a pretty highlighter. I don't know, I don't use it though. Using again a Bella Pro brush angle, so. But yeah, we're done like with the light contouring for today. Like, it looks pretty, it looks subtle, I like it. Now, again, taking a Physicians Formula like blush brush, which I love that it's so big, and taking my MAC Nutcracker Sweets in Sweet Vision, which I bought this not regular price because I'm cheap, but yeah, super pretty. No, I bought this like when it was like 40% off. 40 or 30? 40? I don't remember, but yeah, super cute packaging. Super pigmented. I love a lot of blush, so. Now again, taking a fan brush and taking my favorite highlighter. It's also my only highlighter, but it's the MAC Starstruck like highlighter in Luna Luster. Look at it! Isn't it gorgeous? Bam! Highlighter, can you see that? Of course you can. Like, I used to be afraid of highlighter, but with this one, I'm not. Finally, we are going to do the lips, which I have a new lip shade, which is the ColourPop Ultra Matte Lip in Tool. I bought this off Wish, so it's not like the real one. I know it's not. I know it's fake makeup. So I'm just going to be applying that on my lips. And now super, super duper concentration, because I'm gonna mess this up. Does it look even? And finally, without messing up the eyelashes, just setting it with, again, with my Boscia setting spray. A tad a bit. And then, I broke it. This is the makeup, you guys. Let's let that hair loose, because we don't need to be tied up anymore. And because I want you guys to see my pink hair. And I love it. Okay. So yeah, this is the makeup look. I don't know how I look, so you guys tell me, how do I look? Does it look good? Do you like it? Just comment down below and say. So yeah guys, that was today's video. Hope you guys liked me getting ready. Hope you guys liked me go-to look talking a lot, but hope you guys liked it. Give this video a thumbs up if you did. Also comment down below all the things that I said throughout the video, because I don't remember all the shit that I said, but you guys remember, right? Hope you guys like this video. Oh, and also follow me on my social media. I'm loving Instagram lately, so just follow me on Instagram and I will be liking your pictures. Follow me on Instagram because I love Instagram. The links will be like down below, and also when I'm done talking, and also what was the other one? Instagram, and I don't remember. So it'll all be down below and when I finished with this video. So if you guys, hope you guys like this. And also thanks for watching. Bye. Nail out of this, because who knows?